I'm Jon Schwartz, a house hacker and realtor in Los Angeles, California. You're watching House Hack Los Angeles, and this is my weekly Los Angeles real estate market update for March 9th, 2021. In this update, Punxsutawney Phil emerges from his home to see no shadow and hence announce that spring has arrived. Translation, the market's already heating up in a serious way. But first, if you're watching and thinking, isn't that the guy from Investment Property Nerd? The answer is yes, and this is my new channel, House Hack Los Angeles. So please subscribe here to continue getting my content. I'm changing up the social media persona while it's still just a baby. Same great content, new channel. All right, back to the market update. Each Sunday, I review the week's MLS activity for Los Angeles County to bring you the latest in what's happening in our market. These numbers come straight from the MLS, and you won't find these graphs anywhere else because I make them. If this is your first time watching the weekly update, here's a quick explainer. Each graph covers the previous 12 weeks. The bars represent actual weekly numbers, and the line represents the 4-week trailing average. This smooths out the noise and helps us identify trends. If you'd like to talk further about your house hacking plans in Los Angeles, shoot me an email at john@househack.la. All right, let's get into this week's data. Looking at single family listing activity, we see what looks like good news. Net new listings continue to rise. We have 1,260 new listings, another record week for the year, 294 sales, and 200 expired, withdrawn, or canceled listings this week. The 4-week trailing average of net new listings is up again to 698. Yay, inventory! But then we look at our sales metrics and get hit hard with a big fat what the fuck. Average price per square foot also hit a high for the year at almost $800, extending this 5-week upward trend in pricing. Median days on market continues to drop, and list price to sales price ratio tops 104% for the second straight week, pulling the 4-week trailing average north of 100% for the first time since I started these weekly updates in October of last year. This is bad, people. Let me tell you why. In any open market, when supply goes up, pricing should go down. So why isn't pricing going down in the single family market? Quite simply, demand is also going up. If supply and demand rise in equal proportion, pricing will remain the same. If the rise in demand outpaces the rise in supply, then pricing will increase despite the additional supply. And that's what we're already seeing in the single family market. Home buying is seasonal. Transaction volume really picks up in the spring and summer, largely because a lot of home buyers are families, and families need to buy and sell as one school year is winding down and before the next begins. So what we're seeing is an aggressive start to the 2021 spring-summer buying season. Supply is up, but so is demand. I was hoping that demand would lag supply this year because so many people moved last spring and summer to cope with the pandemic. And once again, my hopes are dashed. It looks like we're heading into another very competitive buying season in Los Angeles. All the more reason to house hack your next home. In condo listing activity, more signs of competition picking up. New listings came in at 521, while sales were at 155, and expired, withdrawn, or canceled listings were at 112. This brings our 4-week trailing average net change in listings down for the second week in a row to 238. Condo market inventory is definitely slowing as we head into the spring season. So if you've been considering a condo purchase, it might be time to jump in. In sales activity, we see metrics that mirror the single family market, but aren't quite as bad. Pricing is trending upward, but we're only $20 per square foot higher than we were 3 months ago. Median days on market is trending down, but we're still higher than we were 3 months ago. And list price to sales price ratio is trending up, but still under 100%. So what does this mean for condo buyers? Things are still relatively okay, but with supply slowing down each week, I expect the metrics to start getting less and less favorable. I think we'll see an uptick in condo sales as more people get vaccinated, and if inventory continues to slow, it'll create a double whammy for rising prices. If you're hoping to scoop up a condo at pandemic pricing, I'd advise you to act sooner than later. That window might be closing. In residential multifamily listing activity, and remember we're talking about 2-4 unit buildings here, new listings are up, sales are down ever so slightly, and expired, canceled, or withdrawn listings are also down ever so slightly. This pulls the 4-week trailing average of net new listings up a skosh to 68. Looking at sales activity, we get a mixed bag. Pricing has backed off its recent highs, thank goodness, but median days on market is trending down, while list price to sales price ratio is trending up. The multifamily market isn't nearly as seasonal as single family and condos, so we're not going to see the same spring surge. I anticipate pricing to slowly climb, and I hope median days on market remains in this higher range. In a month, we're going to review Q1 2021, that's January, February, March, to see how they compare to Q1s from previous years. I'm looking forward to that recap as it will allow us to pull our heads out of the weeds and get a 10,000 foot view on the year so far. So subscribe now and stay tuned for that. Thank you for watching this Los Angeles market update. Please subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss next week's. get in touch with me with your questions about house hacking in Los Angeles, and I'll see you next time on House Hack Los Angeles.